Hey guys, here at Davis AutoSports, we're very excited to offer you an absolutely gorgeous 1984 CJ7. This Jeep has undergone a full restoration. The restoration took place some years back, but it has less than, I believe, 3,000 miles on the restore. This CJ, and we've seen a lot of CJs, guys, this thing is fully built. Fuel injection system, long arm suspension, COILOVERS suspension, 4-disc brakes, wheel wood brake system all the way around, upgraded axles, gears, you name it, it has it, full-blown interior, worn products all the way around it, winch, bumpers, tire carrier, brand new 35-inch tires, were just recently put on less than 500 miles ago. The previous owner, a good friend of mine and to Davis AutoSports, bought this Jeep restored. It had 37s, so we just put these tires on it. They're in phenomenal condition. Since his ownership, it's been garage kept, and obviously after the restoration, it was also garage kept. When we got this CJ in, it was already in incredible condition, and we did go through the entire Jeep mechanically and cosmetically and did make some improvements from it. One of the things that we did, the front worn bumper, rear worn bumper, fender flares, and poison spider side rockers and side steps, we took those off, sandblasted them, and finished them in a black Kevlar coated finish. Gives it a nice aggressive look. The paint has a beautiful shine. We paint corrected the entire vehicle, started with a 1500 grit, worked all the way up to a 3000 grit. From there, we compounded with 3M compound and a wool pad. Then we went with a stage 1 polish and a foam pad, then a stage 2 polish with a ultra polish pad. And then from there, it was sealed. Went through it mechanically. We did put two brand new Optima batteries in it. We did a couple seals and gaskets. Worked on the starter, a couple other miscellaneous things just to get it in tip-top shape. There's a lot of CJs on the market, guys. Very few were built to this magnitude with this much attention to detail. No matter where you look on this Jeep, it's been upgraded. Sway bar systems front and rear, as you see, long arm system. Axles have been upgraded, brakes have been upgraded, full COILOVERS suspension front and rear. I mean, this thing is absolutely awesome. Does have the 4.2. Fuel injection system on the Jeep. We did black out the headlight bezels. They were chrome. There wasn't much chrome elsewhere, so we figured the chrome didn't fit. The Kevlar in person gives it a really nice rugged look. The underneath of this Jeep, guys, is absolutely beautiful. It is a true rust-free CJ7. The frame is perfect. The floor pan is perfect. As you see, the lower marker lights have been blacked out too. For all of our subscribers, you guys are very familiar with our Kevlar package. If this is the first time you're viewing this video, we do a ton of Kevlar on our custom Jeeps. That stuff is very durable, won't come off, and most importantly, when we apply it, we take the panels off. So everything that's Kevlar on this Jeep was removed, prepped properly, sprayed, and then reinstalled. So a lot of time goes into it. As you see, the paint is absolutely beautiful. I do want to point out, guys, it does have your small, very small clear coat issues. They're not all the way through. We do paint work here. We will be more than happy to repaint the hood if requested. This is the worst area right here. It's not peeling. It's one of those things where if you leave the Jeep in the sun for, you know, weeks at a time over the course of a couple years, it will start to get bad. But if it's a garage kept vehicle and it's you know, waxed, then you won't really have an issue. Like I touched on, brand new BFG 35 all-terrain KO2 tires. Wheel wood brakes front and rear. Hey, did a phenomenal job on this body when they did the restoration. The body panels are as smooth as can be, very, very straight. All the lines on the Jeep are absolutely perfect. Now keep in mind, guys, this wasn't a, you know, show quality sort of restoration, if you will. They restored it to be a nice driver quality Jeep, but the CJ, I can guarantee you, looks better than 95% of the CJs that are out there. You're gonna have some typical common Jeep issues with it, you know, some things that we can fix if need be. If you pull on this handle real hard, it will come out just a hair. It bucks out about a quarter inch, but it doesn't come out beyond that. Just typical little Jeep stuff like that. So just expect some minor, typical Jeep little quirky issues, but no damage, no mechanical issues, no issues whatsoever in those departments. Guys, we are shooting this in 4K. It's also being shot in HD. Two formats for you guys, so if you guys have the ability to watch this on 4K, please do so. You'll really get to see the true condition of this Jeep cosmetically. Your big sway bar or sway link system. All stainless steel brake lines, upgraded brake lines. This thing is the real deal, guys. Dana 44 front and rear, upgraded splines. Heavy duty axles inside. We do have a ton of pictures of the frame and undercarriage. Make sure you guys check those out. All the body mounts, very important, are in great shape. Those were redone during the restoration process. Enterprise lockers inside, or excuse me, axles. Hard top is in excellent condition as well. All the window seals all the way around are in great condition. Gas tank, skid plate. Boiler exhaust. Tires are so new, they still have the blue on the white wall. Rear sway system. Frame is absolutely solid as can be as well. an AC converted Jeep. All the gauges work properly. Beautiful 6-point roll cage as well. It was done at the time of the restoration. Continues up front as well. Built-in grab handles. Goes across the lower portion of the windshield. Like I said, guys, there was a ton of money. You guys know we build Jeeps here, and even though this thing was done years ago, it's got very low mileage on the restore, and something like this, considering the paint, the interior, the seats, the axles, all the driveline, the fuel injection system, AC, suspension, wheels, tires, brakes, all the miscellaneous stuff, bumpers, winches, lights, labor, easily, without a doubt, $35,000, $40,000 restoration. Probably, depending on where you go, could cost a lot more than that. That would be a minimum. I would see no problem with a shop that has a huge, you know, $100 to $125 labor rate charging a lot more for this. That may seem high for some of you guys, but for the guys that own businesses and know what it costs to do a full-blown restoration and charge a customer, those aren't inflated numbers at all. So there you guys go. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to contact us directly at davisautosports.com. You can also give us a call at 855-XJ-JEEPS. That comes to 855-955-3377. Thank you.